All right, so I don't know what exactly this is. Is this like a new Valkyrie? A new goose skin? A Valkyrie? It looks pretty awesome, but I kinda already spent all my crystals. Oh. I don't know anything about it. I'm guessing this is just the story for it.
每个人都是一无所知地诞生在世界上，被周遭的一切不由分说地推上了人生的旅途。
Oh, tiny.
随着时间流逝，我们渐渐告别懵懂，观察、学习，向自己的内心不断确认。
I must say, the ancestors look a lot alike.
此生究竟要做一个怎样的人？有时我们足够幸运。
Just reminds me of Himiko.
Oh,
I hate you. I still hate you. Even after everything I've known now, I still hate you. Oh, adorable! Aww. Oh, look at it! Tiny! Wait, she got white in her hair now. That's different.
Huh?
Aye. Wow, he looks a lot like my brother. Like, scary so. Same eyebrows, same eyes, same skull structure of the face. And same hair. What the heck? Scary. You know, seeing the Homu Homu festival or carnival, it makes you really wish that was a thing. That would have been so awesome. This is a pretty big close-up. Can we zoom out a little, please? I never stand this close to someone. Gosh, that was such a good scene. Okay, so this is the little making of the new Valkyrie suit. Okay, legit question. So she was like a prodigy when she was younger, right? So now that she's older, you know how she said like she's her skill is basically just barely on par with everyone else's, like Kiana's and stuff? Does that mean that she's no longer a prodigy? Or does that mean that there's just more prodigies? It makes you curious, and I'd like to know your guys' thoughts on that. Like, is her skills waning? Or is it just others are also... She's finally being able to meet others. Others like her. Gosh, I hate this scene. That scene in particular, like, it makes it look so much like they're husband and wife, or that they're dating, and I hate that. I don't even want that to be a thing. I hate it that it feels portrayed that way. I can't be the only one that feels that.
形形色色的这类矛盾。无论如何，尤兰达尔并没有被这些历史问题所束缚住，他始终迈步向前，诚实地接受着关于自身的一切，并把它们悉数内化为最强自己的一部分。
And he has the glasses I actually want. I can't wear those kinds of glasses because my frames are too thick. The glass. Even with the trimming. So envious.
Yeah, 抱着这样的疑问，我们首先要追溯的是这个形态下幽兰戴尔力量的来源。
Power.
一是卡斯拉纳家族所代表的崩坏兽的力量，二是沙尼亚特家族所代表的圣血的力量。前者意味着
all the way back，
后者则是接纳和进化，就像事物的两极。很快我们就萌发了以一黑一白作为象征的创意。
一黑一白两种力量的
博弈。So, this is a lot like yin and yang, isn't it?
天元的概念。天元。
The power difference between the two, it's just like yin and yang, isn't it? Every time I see black and white, that's what I think of, and it reminds me of Fuhua, how like she has a balance. That's what.This power kind of reminds me of, but this one's like two sides of like, I don't think you can attain the other side.
之间的对立和统一。在我们眼中，天元这个词。
Oh, that's really cool. I never knew there was a cloth version of this. I've only seen the wooden board.
在如今的幽兰戴尔身上，两种截然不同的圣痕之力，卡斯兰纳的人为崩落和沙尼亚特的圣血进化。他们不再彼此抵消。
Look at all that tomato juice.
相得益彰。他正像一名驾驭了烈马的骑士，把每一份力量都统合在了新的共同体之下。
我们想让玩家在这套装甲里看到他之前所有战斗方式的影子，而这是一个形态远不足以承载的。在设计的初期，我们先有了做骑士形态的想法，让荣光。
Oh, that's why she has. That's why she has a horse.
给了我们做卫士形态的灵感。星毛则启发了我们将铠甲转换为战马，完成形态的切换。
I actually really like that one, the third one.
形态的概念就此成型了。
I try to get it, but I keep running out of crystals when it's around.
戴尔的盾并给它设计成了翅膀的造型，这暗示着兽的寓意。翅膀上蓝色的能量，背后尖锐的黑色骨骼结构，也暗示着这股能量的危险和强大。在使用沙尼亚特之力之后，黑色的盔甲呈现脱落，组成了威风凛凛的战马。
Oh my goodness！
马的身上
That's so cool！
部分黑色甲胄的细节。
It looks so awesome in 2D。
这个形态其实更具神圣。
It looks great in 3D too. And oh my goodness！
它总是柔和的白金色。
Ooh, that outfit is pretty spicy.
构成。That's
really nice。
相较之前的黑色战甲，它显得更加的柔和。当然，柔和并不是弱小。我们可以从白金色
white gold gradient hair tip show. Okay, I was wondering about that. So does that mean her hair is gonna go full white eventually? I wonder what that looks like.
就必须让这个角色同时拥有两种可以自如切换的战斗形态。抛开工作量翻倍的问题，最困难的是如何让骑士驾驭他的战马。
Yeah, I can't imagine that because the way you move on the mount is kind of annoying in a lot of games. So I'd like to see how this works.
这是非常困难的，而且几乎找不到成熟的参考。但是退缩不是我们的风格，就像幽兰戴尔将他的历练融汇进了这套装甲。我们一直以来的技术积累，就是为了等待某天新挑战的到来。这一次，我们觉得时候到了。
天元奇鹰巨大的工作量和制作难度，对于我们来说无疑是一次新的挑战。这是我们第一次在崩坏三中做角色的四足骑乘。
Oh, I like that guy's jacket. It's like a teddy bear.
仅仅是骑兵的移动方式，我们就足足做了四种：慢跑、快跑、冲锋和走路。在骑士形态的制作中，我们希望马能够真正的参与到攻击中去，而不是仅仅是代步工具。
Doesn't he look a lot like the Persona 5 character?Doesn't he look a lot like Joker? It's so cool. I like his hair.
So,
I should be focusing more on this, I know, on the actual Durandal, but I get distracted with these side things.
下落踩地攻击来举怪，而是利用马从空中往下冲的力度和惯性，来增加角色刺出长枪的重量感。
Okay, so you still do the charge. Good. That's actually one of my favorite things.
特殊与骑士的张力。我们还变革了幽兰戴尔标志性的投机动作，缩短了
The throw animation，
让天元骑鹰拥有更加紧凑的投机体验。
Oh, show it.
小投机突出简洁迅速。
What？
大投机突出力量感。
Oh, I don't like it.
打到大型怪物的时候，配合一段强有力的冲刺，为开破蓄力，来实现更加强烈的打击感。
The charge up is really cool.
在我们马上，我们进行了新的尝试，
I didn't like the grapple.
武器技大多是释放单一技能，有很长的 CD。在手游按键资源稀缺的现状下
，It's not as stylish。
这一次我们尝试将武器技融入角色的连段，用冷兵器搭配火器，让玩法更加有趣和多样化。按照定位，两个形态并不存在绝对的强弱差异。骑士形态的战斗体验是通过持续移动作战和冲击力来对付一些高机动性的敌人，而卫士形态更注重博弈与对抗，在应对一些
侵略性比较强
的敌人时更加有效。玩家可以选择一直用单一形态进行作战，也可以通过形态切换。
That's actually very interesting.
更丰富的战斗策略。
Yeah, I think I know how I would use it.
在制作的过程。
With the way they explained it, I think the way I would end up using it, let me know if you guys already have it and have been using it in the CN version, but the way I would use it is the knight form where it's with the horse. I would use that to clear the regular enemies when there's multiples to get around and everything. But then once it gets to like the final boss or like a trial boss, I swap to the other form. What do you guys think? Let me know.
过程中如何平衡骑士形态与卫士形态的表现也是我们遇到的难点之一，因为骑士形态自带一匹体型巨大的马，但从视觉效果上来说它就会比卫士形态要强烈一些，因此我们给卫士形态设计了很多不同的动作。单从风之攻击来说，它就有盾反后开炮、盾反后普通攻击、盾反后蓄力以及盾反后强力蓄力等等等表现，
I like characters that can counter.
配合上我们的特效以及镜头，使得骑士形态和卫士形态可以一起并驾齐驱，完整的构成我们天元骑营。
天元之路在此开拓。
天元骑营是我们崩坏三在制作角色上的又一次突破，它第一次在角色上实现了两种形态的并存和切换，使得骑士能够真正的驾驭战马。
她是原本的齐安娜、齐格菲和塞西利亚的亲生女儿。
Wait, for the first time, wasn't her form with the golden arrow? I can't remember the name. Something to do with horoscopes, but doesn't that one have two different forms? Like while you're using the ultimate? I could have sworn it changed.
如今的比安卡
Just slightly, not like a big difference, but I'm pretty sure it changed.
不屈不挠地走出了一条属于自己的道路。
从荣光月破星毛再到天元骑营，我们希望玩家能够看到他过去的影子，看到他战斗方式的融汇。他一个人就是一支军队，是能够适应任何作战环境的最强形态。
但他的强大并不是凭空造就的，这全都来源于他最基础的战斗方式和基本功。这也是天元其中的一层含义。
无论何时
That is my favorite form right there.
都必须不断努力，不断变强。
That's the one I was talking about. Oh, I want it.
天元在数学中有未知数的含义，而在围棋当中，天元也属于绝对的冷门开局，被认为只有人工智能才能驾驭它的无穷变化。但无论是尤兰戴尔还是瓦尔特乔伊斯，我们最终都是想借他们的身影去说明，做好身边一点一滴的事，就是
You know, seeing these past scenes, these past cutscenes, it makes me just kind of want, like, I want them to do like a flashback where you play as the smaller versions of them and like kind of like move around towns and stuff. I don't think they did that, and if they did, for some parts,I'm sure they didn't do it well enough for it to impact me into remembering it, so.
初心的最好注解就是拓展人生价值的真正道路。
I'm not too confident with my memory.
在这条道路上不断前行着的他们会以自己的信念聚集起身边的同伴，并将这种意志传递给并肩作战的每一个人。随着尤兰戴尔以天元骑鹰的形象到来，他忠实的战友丽塔也将以新的身姿与他并肩作战。
Oh yes, I also want that one. I want that Valkyrie suit.
大家的人，丽塔将把缭乱星级化为她手中最瑰丽的锋刃。
I really love her hair in that one.
故事，大家也将在之后的相关内容中逐渐了解。在随后的主线剧情中，奥托相关的故事就要在最后的高潮中落下帷幕，而圣痕所蕴藏的力量， 也借由幽兰戴尔的觉醒露出了冰山一角。
在未来的剧情中，我们将会看到天元奇鹰与圣痕计划之间的潜在联系，而到那时，崩坏三的主线故事也将翻开决定性的一页。让我们一同见证。
Gosh, it's finally coming to an end. Oh my goodness.
这就是传承的力量。
Oh my gosh, it's, I can't believe it. It's almost over. Honkai Impact's story is almost over, just hearing that. So does that mean there's no Honkai Impact 3rd version 6? Are we just going straight to like Honkai Star Rail? I don't know, but if you guys know, let me know. Because I want to know that for sure. My goodness, I really like this one. I really do.I shouldn't have used my crystals on Bronya. I really wanted Bronya, but at the same time, why did I do that? Because I'm already playing Bronya in the post-Honkai, so it's like, it's not too much of a new gameplay. Like, sure, there's some new skills, but like, it's not too different. You know what I mean? But then this one is like super nice.When it comes to the actual gameplay though, like, I like her for her style, I like her lore story, and I like the design. I don't really like, I don't know, it doesn't feel too different. Like, the charge attack, for instance, the only thing that's different to me with the charge attack is the fact that, like, oh, you're on a horse now, so you don't have to run with your legs.The horse's legs. That's it. And then the grappling actually looks worse, in my opinion, but it makes sense that it would work like that. Like, realistically, that's how it goes, but this game shouldn't even be emphasizing on that, because it's a fantasy game for one. I do like her other form, though. So maybe if I actually saw more gameplay of her other form, I might be able to conduct, like, a much better opinion on it.But this form in particular, it seems so much similar to like her other Valkyrie forms where she just runs around charging at enemies. So, it's all dependent on the other part. I'm pretty sure I didn't get to see much of the other part even when I was watching this. It showed more of... Oh, here it is. Yeah, it only shows like the slowdown and stuff, and then it swapped back instantly. I think I need like a hands-on test of this, truth be told. I need to try it out for myself. But, I don't know. Let me know what you guys think of this one, because... Like...I'm on the fence of it. Maybe I'll just get Rita and just call her good. Alright, I'll see you guys later with more Honkai Impact, yeah? Peace.